Welcome to the 2021 Heart of America Athletic Conference Women's Soccer Media Day. I'm Erik Bergrud, color commentator for the Kansas City Comets of the Major Arena Soccer League. Next up, we are joined by head coach Bryce McClanahan of MidAmerica Nazarene. Coach, how are you doing today?
Hey, I'm doing well. Thank you, Erik.
Appreciate it. Thanks for being with us. First off, can you tell us a little bit how your preseason camp is going? What are some of the positives you've seen from your team so far?
Sure, absolutely. We've had a very good preseason so far. Obviously, I think preseason for me, it's kind of like the honeymoon phase of a wedding, of a marriage. For me, that's kind of where we're really focused on kind of just like the fundamentals, building strong relationships, strong team chemistry, team bonding. There really isn't any storms right now. So everybody, you know, is eager to go and earn playing time to earn starting spots. But for us, we have a mixed group. So we have 11 new players into the group, and another half is returners. So we're very excited about the group that we have. Of those 11, we have seven incoming freshmen, and then we also have four transfers as well that we're excited about.
Excellent. So last year was, I guess I could say it was very 2020, and amidst everything, your squad finished an impressive fifth in the Heart. What is it going to take to jump into the top four in 2021 and make a run at the NAIA National Tournament?
Sure. Yeah. So when things ended in the fall, we actually did finish in the top four. So it was credit to the girls. They earned a home game in the conference tournament. But then obviously we lost to Benedictine there, and they went on to the national tournament. So for us, we were in the mix. I think the goal for us is to always look to go and compete and finish kind of in the top three. So it's a tough conference. You've got some strong teams. I think this past spring, we had four or five teams in or receiving votes in the top 25. So for us, I think the goals never change, but it's just now just making sure that we are detail oriented on a daily basis, showing up with urgency and intensity. And we have a great coaching staff we've got some things rolling out in regards to tactics, the way that we want to go and play this year. So very excited about it. But in the same way, kind of like our same principles, our identity, those things don't change. So, just excited going into my third year. Just feel extremely comfortable, confident, excited about where we're at.
So when I talk to Heart coaches, everybody wants to talk about the team and not so much about individuals. So let me start with the team. What are your team goals this year as you look forward to the fall season?
Sure. Yeah. No, like I had mentioned, for us, our aim is always the top three, right? The objective is to go and win a conference championship. MNU women's soccer has not done that. We finished as high as second twice this past year, finishing in fourth. For us, if we're playing, we're going to go and try and win every game that we play. So I think that's one of the goals. Also in the past, we've been as high as number 18 in the country. For me, I'd love to go beyond that, maybe in the top 15 of the country. Like I mentioned, it's a very good conference, and you have to go and show up. You can't sleep on any team. So our goals, they don't change. My first year in charge, we went to the NAI National Tournament opening round. I think that was a great first step for us. Now it's not just getting to that point. We want to go and get to a final site. So for me, this fall, as well as kind of the next few years coming up, that would be kind of that next measurable step, so to speak, measurable goal for us.
So you have the distinction of being an MNU alum. How much does your university mean to you, and how has it shaped you into the coach you are today?
Man, MNU has been an amazing place. I would say very transformational. So I played 2 years here for the men's soccer team. Kevin Wardlow is my coach. I loved playing in the team that he created, just a great team culture. So many international guys. But I think probably the biggest thing was I was able to be authentically myself. I wasn't trying to be something that I wasn't. And for me as a player, I was just like a simple guy. I was going to show up, work hard, And then I think it's also important that you've got talent. And so in my team that I played in, had a lot of talent. And so now I kind of transitioned, obviously, into a coach for the women's soccer team, 2 years as an assistant, and now going into my third year as the head coach. But yeah, for me, MNU isn't just a place I show up and get to work. It's a place that's transformed me. It's given me an opportunity to go and impact people. So I don't take that lightly.
To help fans get to know you better and maybe your influences, what are your favorite professional soccer teams?
Yeah, my team has always been Manchester United. Yeah, growing up with the likes of like watching Cristiano Ronaldo, Paul Scholes, Rio Ferdinand, Vidic. That was like the glory days of Manchester United. As of recently, it hasn't been so great, but things are kind of turning around. But yeah, follow English Premier League soccer pretty closely. And then Manchester United's always been my go-to team.
They look pretty good against Leeds in their opener. So
yes, there we go.
So final question, Coach. 2020 was a challenge, but 2021 looks optimistic in terms of people on campuses, some sense of fan bases. If you were to deliver a message to the MNU student body, to families, to parents, getting them excited about this fall, what would you tell them?
Yeah, absolutely. I think going on from this past year is crazy. I think that there is potentially a lot of fear. You can kind of feel it in the air. But for us, we don't want to go and make decisions with fear in our minds. I think it was amazing. At the end of the day, we were able to get a fall season in. Into the spring, we were able to go and play our conference tournament. And so right now, we're like, man, hopefully we can go and beat COVID. It seems like now there are some, you know, safety precautions, potentially like masks on campus. But for me, I'll wear a mask all day long if it means that we're able to have classes here on campus, if it means that we're able to go and have training sessions, have a true normal fall season. So I think the biggest thing is we're going to be safe. We're going to be disciplined in the way that we go about things. And specifically with women's soccer, we're going to go and set the example here on campus. So.
Coach McClanahan, thank you so much for joining us today and good luck this season.
All right. Thank you, Erik.